Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Abby. This is my photography channel. If you want to go check out my vlog channel, I'll link that below. And I post on here every Wednesday and sometimes Friday. And I'm either doing a tutorial video behind the scenes or just informational. I'm just trying to document my process as I'm building my brand. And I just want to share it with you guys and just have it for myself to look back on and see how far I've grown. And I think YouTube is a really fun place to do that and to share things, and so you guys can see this and then I can have it for myself. Today's video is not, I'm not trying to be negative or anything. I'm just explaining things that I have noticed and things that I kind of want to warn you about as a photographer or a creator. I made a list, so let's get started. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe, please. So I'm gonna share like a con or like a negative, and then I'm gonna share a positive thing. One of the first things, especially this has been like the biggest thing for me, is people using me. And this could mean fake friends, people just being like, hey, let's hang out, but like also could we shoot some pictures? Like I used to just be like, oh, okay, like yay, like people wanna hang out with me. No, they just wanted their photo taken, which is ridiculous because it's just photos. If you really want photos done, go outside and take some on your iPhone, sweetie. But to kind of flip that around, if people are using you like that, just think like, oh, then I must be kind of good at this. That's what I kind of realized and took it as. I mean, I don't let people like walk all over me, and people don't use me anymore. But eventually I was like, oh, like people are using me. Yes, I get that. But now I realized that they were using me because maybe my photos are better than I thought they were. That made me feel better, and I also just like stopped putting up with people using me and having their photos being taken for free, because I used to not be super positive about my work. I wasn't my biggest fan. I was just doing it kind of for fun and with my friends, and I didn't even take myself seriously. So if you aren't taking yourself seriously, you need to start doing that. And I started charging, and then I finally got the hang of it, and now I charge like what I think I'm worth. Don't let people use you. Make sure you're charging people for your work. If you think you're ready to charge, charge people. If a lot of people are using you, then you can get clients. People are going to pay for your work. A pro is nowadays it's really, or at least for me, what I felt, it's really easy to market myself with all of the social media apps. Like you can post all over, especially now with TikTok. If you post a video of you behind the scenes, I do that most of the time I shoot, it could blow up. You never know what's gonna happen. Watch videos about marketing, and that's what I do all the time. Ask questions to other like bigger photographers, and you never know, they'll probably answer. Most of the time when I've asked people questions, they've answered me. If you have a question, feel free to even ask me. I'll try to help you out, even though I'm not like up there, but I'll try to help you out. I don't know if this is everywhere or just Utah, but it seems like sometimes, or it like feels like to me for a second there, I was like, I can't handle social media anymore. I was like, it just feels like a competition between all these other creators, because to me sometimes it feels like everyone's doing the same things and shooting the same things, and everyone's like copying each other. And it's not, it's one thing to be like inspired by someone else, like inspired by another photographer, but you can't copy it to a T. Yes, I am inspired and get ideas from other people, but I never once copy it to a T. I always try to put my own spin on it. And lately I've been just trying to make up my own stuff. I've tried to not even look at Instagram for ideas, or even Pinterest. Sometimes I do. I just try to find things around my house to just shoot with and just come up with my own original ideas, because I feel like it's such a competition because everyone's shooting. I think I put this as a con too, that everyone's also shooting at the same locations here. And it's really, I've never gone to like one of the basic locations in Utah. That's like my goal, is to not shoot where everyone else does, because I hate it so much. It's not like I'm trying to be super different either. I'm literally just trying to be who I am, and being someone else is not being who I am. So I don't know how these people are copying and feeling good about their work. Wow, I'm really sounding rude right now. But some people I've talked to, they'll be like, oh yeah, like so-and-so did. we should do that because so-and-so did it. And I'm like, no, then I don't want to do it. Like, just because, I don't know, it's just really frustrating because there's so many small photographers like me, I feel like, and we're all trying to make it, but you're not going to make it if you're not being yourself. To flip that around, just be you, be genuine, make art that is you. All I do is post weird crap, I swear. And I love it. I feel good about it. Post what you feel good about. Just stop worrying about what the bigger photographers are posting. Just like take a step back and ask yourself if you're being like real and if you're making content that you love. A pro is with social media, you can share your work whenever you want. Like literally whenever. One time I posted a series and I posted like 12 photos in a day or something. Like I felt good about it because I wanted to do that. But I don't think people realize you can post whenever you want. You don't need to post once a week or like have a posting schedule or whatever. I've never really believed in that. I just have always posted when I want to post. And if I make something, I think it's super cool. I'm like, okay, I'm posting this right now. I don't know. You don't need to wait. Just post it. You can post your work whenever on whatever platform you want. It's awesome. Like, we're so lucky to have that. I think I kind of already talked about this. This is a con, but even comparing your work to other people's work. I don't really do this anymore, but for a second I would do it and just be like, oh my gosh, like, why didn't I think of that? They're so cool. Like, why don't my photos look like this? How doesn't my editing look like this? I think it was mainly like an editing thing for me. I'm like, how do they edit like that? Why can't I edit like that? My photos don't look like that. Don't stop. Don't do that. Mm-mm. That digs you in deep and it's hard to get back up because you're just making yourself more insecure and that doesn't help you one bit. That doesn't help you at all. Pro, you can build an audience for yourself. Again, social media, people will find you. I already wrote this down as a pro too, but it's super easy to reach out to people and find friends and models, and people are going to respond back. People are going to work with you. You will find someone that will want to work with you. For a while, I couldn't get anyone to work with me because I wrote this down as a con. I wasn't posting because I didn't think my work was good enough and didn't have enough followers. I had like 100 or 200 followers, I think. And not gonna lie, people, this is really sad, but people aren't gonna wanna respond to you if you have barely any content and you don't have any followers. It's really sad, but it's literally the truth. Like, no one wanted to work with me besides like friends and family and stuff, but no one would respond to my DMs. I would reach out to so many people. Like, I remember every night I would just reach out to like 10 different models and makeup artists and no one would respond to me. It was very hurtful, but I didn't understand why. I still don't think followers determine your worth and how good your work is and how much business you're getting. It doesn't matter because, yeah, even when people weren't responding to me, I was still shooting. I was still making money. I was still taking photos of people, but no one wanted to work with me model-wise and like editorial creative shoot-wise, and that's what I love to do the most. So that kind of hurt. But if you're reaching out to people and no one's responding to you, it's okay, it happens. But every once in a while, one would respond back to me and I'd work with them or I'd talk to them. Never give up. Keep reaching out to people. Keep reaching out to models. Keep asking people questions. Someone will eventually respond to you. I kind of already mentioned all these in the beginning, but to me, and I feel like lately for some reason, everyone's been saying they've been in a creative slump and they don't know what to shoot. Sometimes, usually when that happens to me, I've definitely had that happen before and I just was like, why don't I want to like shoot? Why can't I go out and shoot? I just feel so like right now, like, why am I feeling like this? And I think I was just, I've been taking photos, like I've been grinding super hard since last summer, and after I went on a trip to California and I was shooting like 1 to 2 shoots a day and then like editing for a few hours and then shooting and then editing and shooting, it was just like I got home and I think I was really just like burned out. I didn't shoot for like a week or two or a few weeks. It was really hard for me to get back into it, but it happens. Usually now if it happens, if I get it like a little bit, if I'm like there's nothing to shoot, I literally just make myself go and shoot something super simple. Like I'll wear all white or I'll do something, and not all the time. You don't have to post everything you shoot too. yes, I've definitely been there, but everyone's been saying they're kind of like in a slump lately, and I think it's because of everything that's going on in the world, and everyone was kind of just stuck at home and not being able to shoot. So once you get out of the habit of shooting all the time, you're going to need a second to start back up again. If you feel like you're in a slump, just be patient. It'll all be fine. People are all shooting at the same locations, and it's like funny because I'll see one person go there, I'll see a photographer go somewhere, then like that whole week it'll be like the next day it's like someone else went there. Just like funny to watch because it's just like why do people do that? I literally couldn't tell you. It really kind of bothers me though that people just hop on the trends. They'll just like copy what everyone else is doing. Like one time I posted something and I got so many messages like, where is this? And it's so funny to me. So it's like, go find somewhere that you like. Yes, I told them where it was and stuff. Like, I don't care, but also I don't know why everyone feels the need to just go to the same place as someone else did, when there's plenty of areas to shoot, plenty of things no one has shot at before. And I appreciate photographers that go to the super cool spots that no one else has been and that no one else can find. I'm not opposed to sharing where I shoot because I think that's funny when photographers do that too. They're like, they don't want to share where they shoot for this reason, but I think that's kind of dumb too because I think you should be able to share where you shoot. It's just sad that so many people want to go there just because it looks pretty. You know, like there's so many spots that you can shoot at and you can find locations on your own. That's basically all of them. These are just things I've kind of noticed recently. Instagram world, the photography world is kind of crazy stuff. It's kind of a hassle working with people sometimes and just communicating with people. Some people can be very rude, like very disrespectful, but you kind of just have to ignore that and just keep doing what you're doing and make sure to just be yourself always, because being someone else is not gonna get you anywhere. Just stay you, stay unique, stay original, and trust me, people will find you, they'll find your work, and you will do awesome things. So thank you for listening to me rant for about 20 minutes. I hope you all have a wonderful day, or night, or morning. Thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe. I post videos on here every Wednesday and sometimes Fridays. And go check out my Instagram. And if you have any questions, please feel free to message me. I will definitely answer them. Help you out in any way that you need. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next week. Bye.